need to find you to do them so you can keep your clothes on all the time.
Night or its darkness.
You see, the nighttime is the time where we are tempted. The nighttime is the time where we go so that we can take our clothes off. So that we can be who we used to be. We've been clothed in Christ Jesus when we gave our life to Him. And we need to make sure that we keep our clothes on tight in the name of Jesus. Keep your clothes on. New Testament scripture in Romans 13 and 14, and thank those who read the scripture, reminds us that when we gave our lives to Christ, we were given new clothes to wear.
Amen.
Old things have passed away. Behold, I am a new creature. Here's what the Lord does not want you to be: a quick change artist. Heavenly Lord. Some people can be so quick. I got my clothes of righteousness on here. I'm in the darkness here. I got my Our fight, our battle is to keep our righteous clothes on. It doesn't make any difference what happens. The devil's going to test you. Oh, look out. Watch this. When you wear your clothes of righteousness, you identify yourself to the enemy, which is might as well be putting a target right on you, because he's coming at you, and what he wants you to do is to take your clothes off. He wants that person to get on your last nerve so that you can say those words that you used to say. He wants you, in the name of Jesus, hallelujah, your cousin who's been talking about you for so long, been getting up in your face, and you're supposed to be a child of God, clothed in righteousness. But the one word, the one instance, the one example that they give you, all of a sudden you try to get out your door as fast as you can. In the name of Jesus, God says, I got that. I'm with you. Keep your clothes on. In the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. He ain't got a flesh. He ain't got to talk about it. I know that there's temptation. But you see, if you look at the men of Nehemiah, watch this. Here's what they did. They worked and they worked, but they made sure that they kept their clothes on. No matter what happened, they can work on the wall, look over and see the enemy. The enemy is talking trash. That's all the enemy could do. The enemy was saying, get off the wall. It's not going to work. It's not that the devil is a liar. And so they kept their clothes on. Because see, it would have been easy. They had bows, they had arrows, they had spears. It would have been, oh, you going to talk some more? Oh, yeah, come on, man. I'm getting ready to fight. They could have come down off the wall. But that's what the enemy wants you to do. He wants you to come off the wall. He wants you to come out of Jerusalem in the night. And so I came by this morning to say, keep your clothes on. My sister, she sees this text, she don't never see it. But she always, Pastor, I was getting ready to take my clothes off. And watch this. The enemy will help you take your clothes off. The enemy will help you. Y'all just do like this. He wants you to shed your righteousness. He wants you to shed. The Bible said, and it says in Nehemiah, it said in Romans, that we are clad in an armor of light. Right? God sends us into the darkness so that our light will shine. So what happens when you take your clothes off? When you take your clothes off, the light gone. So now you all up in darkness. And in darkness, they're going to start beating on your head. And you will revert to being who you were before you put your clothes on. Turn your neighbor and say, keep your clothes on.
Keep your clothes on.
Every day, everything is always something that's gonna make you want to remove your righteousness, because I want to give them a piece of my mind. Somebody could have got that. I'm just going to give them, you see, because here's what we want to do. Here we go, hold on. Girl, you know I'm going to pray for you. Our as children of God is to keep our clothes on no matter the attack, no matter the confusion, no matter the worry, no matter the fear, no matter the storm. Repeat after me, keep your clothes on. Stay in righteousness. The devil is all, oh, man, the devil's having a good time. Boy, just think, the devil just coming here and just like, oh, I got you, I had got you. Oh, yeah, I remember getting you.
Rebuke you, Satan.
I don't know too many people who might be able to pass that thing. But this is our responsibility. This is our calling. This is what the Lord tells us to do. Keep your clothes on. You are representing Christ. You are putting on the uniform. If you watch football this afternoon, there's not going to be anyone out there on the field running around with no uniform on. You identify yourself by the team that you are on, and you are on Team Jesus in the name of Jesus. Team Jesus. And he has values, he has morals, he has a mission. His mission is to make disciples of Jesus Christ and transform the world. That's what you're supposed to be doing on Team Jesus. And you can't do that when you're taking your clothes off, because you got to give somebody a piece of your mind. And then you have to put your clothes back on and repent. Because when you put your, once you give somebody a piece of your mind, you put your clothes back on, your light ain't even shining. Lord God, please forgive me, forgive me. So you keep asking for forgiveness until your light turns on. Huh? How about keeping your light on? How about that?
Amen.
How about that? You're representing Christ. Huh? You're representing Solace. You're representing St. Matthew's. Amen? So when somebody, you know, you're gonna give somebody a peace of mind over here. Right?
Yeah.
And somebody watching you, you didn't see him watching you because you were so busy giving somebody a peace of your mind. And then you're gonna go, girl, you need to come to church. And they're saying, that church? Huh? It says keep your clothes on and continue to do the work God calls you to do. See, we can't quit doing the work in the name of Jesus. The one thing that we learned from Nehemiah is that the work must continue. And not only did they keep the word, not only did they keep their clothes on, they kept the sword. The sword is the word of God. Amen? You have to keep the word of God with you in the midst of your battles. Amen? Keep your clothes on so that you can represent our Lord and our Savior, Jesus the Christ. Keep your clothes on. Keep your clothes on so that when people see you, they know what team that you're on. They know that you haven't changed teams last night because of what you must do. Help me, Lord. Well, I just went there to watch. Colossians 3:12, therefore, as God's chosen people, holy and dearly loved, clothe yourself in compassion, kindness, humility, gentleness, and patience. Clothe yourself every day. When we're in church, we gotta put on Jesus. At work, put on Jesus. No matter where we are, we have to make sure that we keep our clothes on and put on Jesus wherever we are, because we're the only example of what seeing Jesus looks like. Amen?
Amen.
And we can continue to do the work. Yeah, the enemy's coming. He's trying to discourage you. He's trying to knock you down. But the one thing that you need to know, that when you're angry, keep your clothes on. When things aren't going your way, keep your clothes on. When someone is on your last nerve, keep your clothes on. When someone gets in your face or the face of your children, oh, no, no. Lies on and represents you, throws you under the bus and rolls over you. As a child of God, keep your clothes. I believe the Bible says, God said, vengeance is mine. So no matter what your clothes, you turn over to Jesus, he's going to take care of it a lot better than you can. In the name of Jesus, this God who will fight for you. See, we've got to learn that, because in the world it tells us, snap off, go off, and apologize later. But God is trying to teach us, no, you will just be calm and cool and understand, I got you, everything is going to I'm gonna walk up there. I'm gonna walk away and peep over my shoulder and just like, you know, I'm gonna watch the fight. Huh? Because God's fighting for it, they in trouble. In fact, if someone's trying to steal my last name, I gotta walk away and then pray for them because I said, Lord, not too much. Not too much, Lord. Not too much. I know they would have been. Lord, grace. Grace. Give them a little grace. Just a little. We have to learn to keep our clothes on. Because see, we need to be armed. We always need to be ready. Always clothed in righteousness. Always ready with the armor of God on us. Because we are representing Jesus Christ. So how do we keep our clothes on? Hebrews 12 and 12 suggests keep your eyes fixed on Jesus. Hebrews 12 and 2. Joshua 1 and 8 tells us to meditate on his word day and night. Psalms 119 and 11 tells us to hide the word in our hearts. 1 Thessalonians 5 and 17 says, pray without ceasing. Proverbs 3 and 5 tells us to lean not to our own understanding, but in all ways acknowledge him. He will direct our path. The bottom line is that in the midst of all the things that are going on, we represent Jesus. We clothe in righteousness. This God who has loved us and done so much for us. It is his expectation that his children is just like y'all. Your parents, when you left your house, you represented your parents, right? Amen. And I know for me, I didn't want to get caught, help me look, out there doing something that got back to my parents because I represented them. Amen. Our children represent us. Our children's children represent us. We represent our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ, who's clothed us, blessed us. And so in the challenge, this we understand. The enemy is always coming. The enemy does not like you clothed in light. The enemy does not like when you get blessed. The enemy does not like when someone attacks you and you simply walk away. Clothed in your righteousness. The enemy doesn't like that when you stand. And the enemy is coming at you. And you stand. Hallelujah. Clothed in righteousness. Clothed with the armor of God. Getting ready to watch God win another. Amen. So I want to encourage you today in the name of Jesus. This is about our personal responsibility. This is about who we are as we continue to build up ourselves as children of God and build up our churches in the community that he's in. The enemy is coming. The enemy is at us. Keep your clothes on. I was talking to someone who was a child of God and said, I told them. In the long run, what you told them said something to them. Now, if they don't know Jesus, what does that say? What does that say? Why should I come to Jesus if that's how you believe? Amen.
Amen.
And all that they do, watch the nighttime. Stay in your Jerusalem. Find your Jerusalem and stay there. Find your peace. Find your completeness. Find your harmony. There's a place. Get with our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ, so that he can teach you and mold you and make you into who you are supposed to be, who you were created to be. Find him. Stay in your Jerusalem. Don't wander out at night. Sometimes we just got to look at the caller ID and not answer the call.
Come on.
We know that is temptation.
Yes.
And once you step outside the walls and start walking with temptation, trouble falls.
Yes.
Trouble falls.
Amen. Amen.
I need to follow this church. Mm-hmm. Father God, we give you glory and honor and praise today. Because you're an awesome God.
Yes, Lord.
And Lord, we need your help. We need your help, Lord God, because it's difficult when we are under attack not to fall back into who we used to be. It's difficult, Lord God, when someone wants to fight with us and we're used to being a fight. It's difficult, Lord God, because we haven't been wearing your clothes for a long time. And sometimes we just fail to be patient enough to wait on you to move on our behalf. So, Lord God, it is our prayer today that you help us keep our spiritual clothes on. In the midst of everything, so that we can represent you wherever we go. And people will know that this is a house, that Solomon's is a house of those who, despite everything, they continue to represent Jesus Christ. They are clothed in love and compassion and kindness. Help us, Lord God, because you're going to be sending us out beyond these walls. And help us, Lord God, that people will see you when they see us. Help us, Heavenly Father, that we will also continue the work that you have called us to do. That we will not give up, that we will not quit, that we will not listen to the enemy's wolf tickets. But we will stay fixed and focused on Jesus, the author and perfecter of our faith. Help us, Lord God, for all of us who have fallen off. Help us, Lord God, to put our clothes back on. Forgive us, we pray, in the name of Jesus, that when you walk out of here, Lord God, we will be fully clothed in the armor of light. And we pray that nothing will make us remove that. We're going to lean on, rely on, and trust in you, Lord God, in all that we do. And give you the glory and the honor and the praise. In the awesome and matchless and powerful name of Jesus, we pray. And all God's children say, amen.